once again, ladies and gentlemen, may we have your attention, please? We are near a capacity crowd this evening. And as such, we ask that you please do not block the exits to the gymnasium or the openings of the exit rows at the top of the bleachers. Please do not sit in the walkways, the exit rows of the bleachers. And we ask that you please be a good neighbor and allow as many fans as possible to sit next to you. Once again, please do not block the exits to the gymnasium or openings at the top of the exit rows at the top of the bleachers. Please do not sit in the walkways in the bleachers. Be a good neighbor and allow as many fans to sit next to you as you can. Thank you for your cooperation and support.
Hello, welcome into the Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank. People were screwing with our mics pregame, but now I think we have the auto set how we want. But Asher Salisbury here, Bridger Cruz joins me, and then the rest of our Strive crew. A7 district final basketball, Bridger.
Yep, should be a good one here. It's going to be exciting. Kearney hasn't seen this kind of a district battle since, well, if you want to take a look at it, last time they were even...
Here, why don't we both just pull up our stats?
Last time Kearney was at state was 2019. They lost to Omaha South 59-55. But the reason I bring that up, that's been 5 years since they've been a state. And that year, they were on the road for that district championship game. Meaning, Kearney hasn't seen this big of a game in quite some time, and we can see that. It is a packed house here in Kearney, nearing capacity. We might actually reach capacity tonight. I was here at 6:10, and I was struggling to get in the door and find a parking spot.
I was here at 5:30, and our rowdy section was already half full, and the doors opened at 5:30.
Absolutely. It should be a good one tonight as well. My name is Bridger Cruz. I'm from Kennesaw High School, not from Kearney. Asher Salisbury from Kearney High.
Get to commentate some Class A basketball with me.
You act like I haven't called Class A before.
I know.
Very used to some Class A ball. This should be a good one as well. I'm very familiar with these teams. We're very familiar as well. It's going to be anybody's game, but the big thing that this could come down to is going to be home court advantage. What kind of an impact does that have tonight on Gretna? We've seen them play in big environments. We've seen them shine on big stages. This one, the biggest of their season, and can they compete is going to be the big thing tonight, Asher.
But Gretna, they have traveled well. Looking at their section right across from us, I'm pointing this way, opposite of where we're standing, their section's also full.
Absolutely, yeah. Gretna fans have traveled well. You know, that's been a big thing for them. You
it
look at football,
final,
basketball, and it is a district finals game. That always
winner,
helps.
Winner goes to Lincoln.
Winner heading to Lincoln. Some bigger upsets in Class A last night. Creighton Prep lost on a buzzer beater.
40-38 in overtime to Southeast.
Yes, to Lincoln Southeast. That was a big one. Fun Strive crew up there at Creighton Prep. Got to hear the call from Alex Tejan up there from Creighton Prep. Super fun one. Should be a good one here tonight as well.
100%, but a little bit. On the first round matchup here, Kearney defeated Grand Island 52-38 in the hot shooting from Ian Piper, 18 points.
Yeah, it's a fun one to see too. Ian Piper, not usually the guy for Kearney. He comes in, he can make the defensive plays, and he's gonna get you boards, but he's not gonna score for you. He's not gonna shine.
Grand Island played that little, it helped though, because when he came in, Grand Island playing that little triangle and two deep.
Yes.
Man marking Ben Johnson, man marking Jacob Weber. I believe Jacob Weber had 5 points on the night.
Yeah.
Ben Johnson only two from the free throw line.
Yeah, small night for them, but that's why Ian Piper was able to step up. And that's important looking at this game is you're going to see the same thing as well from Gretna. Well, we're going to take a bit of a break and be back here for more basketball action. When we return, we'll look at the keys to the game for both teams and a little bit of a statistical rundown. I'm Bridger Cruz with me, Asher Salisbury, here on the Bearcats Sports Network. We'll be back in a bit.
As we welcome you back to the Bearcat Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank. Once again, Asher Salisbury, Bridger Cruz, rest of our Strive crew here, A7 District Basketball. Bridger, we know a little bit about Gretna.
Yes, we do. I was lucky enough to call their game at the Heartland Hoops Classic where they beat Pembroke Hill, beat them 66-51. That was a big game for them. You know, that really gave them some confidence. Pembroke Hill has been a good team, just really starting to get things rolling for that program, but they're a good team, nationally recognized. Gretna was able to come out and get a win by 15 points, 66-51. They've been on a 9-game win streak that was just broken by Bellevue West, but Bellevue West, I think the top team in the state right now. I don't know if you can really
the
argue
the team
it.
To beat.
Yes, truly. Looking to repeat as state champs, they're truly the team to beat. Miller North right up there as well, but I don't know if they're quite at the level that Bell West is at this year.
Gretna, 19-5 record, 8-1 away record,
yes.
Too. One loss, and that was, I believe, it was to Westside. Like, in the third or fourth game of the season.
Yeah. Great, great away record. Gretna has the poise, and they have the skill and the seniorship and the senior leadership to get it done on the road. That's why when we talk about and on a home court advantage, yes, it's a big deal. I mean, Kearney's packed this place, but Gretna's been able to win on the road in tough situations time and time again, and I could see him doing it again today.
Oh, 100%. And then going to their defense. Look for that trap defense or the help defense to come. They want the steals. They're averaging almost 10 a game.
Yeah, definitely that big defense. Against Pembroke Hill, they had so many big steals. That helped them get really keep that game at a distance. They had it at one point 22 points. They were able to keep it at a distance from the steals. And the other thing, from passing the ball. I was able actually to talk to head coach, a hilarious conversation with him. It was really a good one. That's head coach Bill Hurd. I talked to him at halftime of the Heartland Hoops Classic. They were up, but they'd let Pembroke Hill kind of get back in the game. And I go, coach, what happened? You know, what's going on? And he looks me dead in the eyes and he goes, we're not passing the dang ball around. And he could not have been more right. You know, you have four guys that can consistently score. They started to look to get their own points a little bit too much, and things started to fall apart. And you know what they did that second half? Came back, played team basketball. They all got their points, and they played a huge second half. That's going to be a big key to this game, is keeping the passing alive and keeping this as a team basketball game for Gretna.
And then coming back to the steals, off those steals, fast break transition points. That's what they want to try and do tonight. They're averaging just a lot.
Yes.
I believe it's 20 a game, if my math is correct.
I don't know. I didn't do your math. So.
But then going in on Kearney's side, they need to keep, like, handle the ball. No unforced silly turnovers.
Yes.
Which we have seen that have happened in previous games this year.
Well, yeah, and the big thing with Kearney, too, I called their game at the Heartland Hoops Classic against Pathway
South. You called
South.
All the games.
Pretty much I was a voice at all the games, yes, pretty much. But the big thing with them is they had 3 to 4 great minutes a quarter. And then they had 4 minutes where it would look like gum was in the gears. Thank you, Eric Allgood, for that analogy.
That's where it starts to show the shortness of their bench with only having 2, maybe 3 subs.
Yes. And that's going to be the big thing tonight, is if Gretna makes this into a track meet, you better hope Kearney's in shape.
Or you got to have some of those subs off the bench. They got to come in and play lights out.
Ian Piper.
Maybe Jacob Hansen will have a big game
maybe
today.
Jacob Hansen. That's going to be the big thing for Kearney. Having those starting five have a good game. Jacob Weber, Ben Johnson, they need to have a big game. You know, that's going to be essential for them. Can they have a big game? Weber especially. If he can start hitting some threes, spread out that Gretna defense a little bit, let Johnson start working inside. We know Johnson can score at all levels, but if you can let Weber really work on that outside and you can let Johnson get going downhill, let him work inside, that's a pretty tough double threat.
Once again, try and get that lid off of the basket that we saw against Grand Island with only a 52-38. It was 26-20 at half.
Yeah.
Low scoring game.
And I think the big thing you could attribute that to as well would be, you know, taking a look at that game. Those are rivals. They've played each other a lot. Sometimes that second time you play a team, it's a little bit slower.
That was the third time,
yeah.
Maybe it's just a little bit more nervous.
Yeah.
But we're going to come back right after this. We're going to cut our mics real quick for the national anthem. We'll be back right after this. You're watching the Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank.
ties, remove your hats, and feel free to sing along as the Kearney High School Pep Band, under the direction of Dr. Nathan LeFevre, plays our national anthem.
As we welcome you back to the Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank, we're getting ready for starters here in Kearney, A7 District. Winner goes to PBA.
Yeah, you know, couldn't have said it any better myself, Asher. Should be very exciting, you know. Two teams very close. We've talked about that all. Everybody knows the statistics. Everybody knows the keys to the game. Everybody knows the trends. We've said it all. At this point, it's time to play basketball and see what happens.
100%. Once again, wild card points. It's win or go home because of the upset of Lincoln Southeast beating Crane Prep 40-38 in overtime. But starters for Gretna: Alec Wilkins, Landon Prokorski, Alex Wilcoxon, Joseph Veith, and Cade Cook. And let's talk about Cade Cook really quick, averaging 7 rebounds a game.
And 14 points.
He's done the dirty work down low for the Gretna Dragons.
Yeah, and they got to get him the basketball. I mean, that's going to be the big thing tonight, needing to get him the basketball.
As right now on screen, you have the high video made by our Bearcat Vision class.
It's a pretty sweet video.
It is a very sweet video. We might get to see my video later on tonight.
You'll have to let us know if we do.
Maybe.
Maybe. Just maybe. Yeah, and for Kearney, you know, high caliber team. Electric, fun to watch. We just saw that there.
As head coach Drake Baronic yelling compete as we're ready to call some A7 district basketball, Bridger.
Man, I'm excited. I really am.
One of the best rowdy sections we've had tonight. We have a full 12 rows, plus we took up the junior rowdy section, which is another 12 rows and about half, which loud. And also, if we look around the top of our gym on X, Mr. Hoga was trying to find a name. The Palace.
The Palace.
The Palace.
I like that.
I kind of like it. I think we should call it the Palace. But the Palace, almost every single blue bench is full. And then there's a whole bunch of people standing at the top railing.
As it should be, man. This is how high school basketball should be. Towns rallying around their teams, showing their support. You got to think these high schools are the lifebloods of these towns. I mean, everybody grows up through it. That's what makes all these towns really, really special. Tonight we're seeing that in Kearney. Let's get to the starters for the Kearney High Bearcats.
At number 0, Carter Lee, he's going to run your point guard spot tonight. The offense is going to run through him. Then you got number 2, Colt Straka. Play with a lot of heart, a lot of pace. And let's just say, he seems to be clutch in the right moments.
He does.
Jacob Weber, sharpshooter from Arizona. Asher Endorf, Gonna get it done down low. And then number 44, Ben Johnson. He's gonna run the five spot tonight. Start as we're gonna have a tip off between Ben Johnson and then Cade Cook of Gretna. 5'7", Cade Cook. And then Ben Johnson standing at 6'5". You and me, Bridger, we're standing at about 6 foot.
Right around 6 foot.
We'd be a good point guard.
That's if we like puff our chest up a little bit and really try
stand,
to stretch
stand
it.
On our tippy toes.
Yeah, for sure.
As the Rowdies are crazy here in Kearney, we're getting ready for A7 District Basketball. Gretna Dragons versus your Kearney High School Bearcats. Ben Johnson, maybe a little fake out to start the game. But Gretna will start with the ball as a quick three ball up and in by Alex Wilcoxon. Gretna, get it started early.
Gretna's not going to waste any time. You know, they haven't all year. They're an aggressive team. They have the confidence. Let that thing fly if you got it.
As Weber gets it inside, in and out. That's no good for Jacob Weber. As now it'll be Gretna to bring it up. Only 30 seconds in as that is up and no good by Joseph Veith. Now it's Bearcats ball. Ben Johnson's going to shoot the deep three ball. He likes it early. Tie ball game in Kearney.
A little bit of fireworks early. Ben Johnson, that's a shot he's been known to hit.
Little deep three ball almost at the volleyball lines. As now that three ball up and no good. Air ball by Alec Wilkins. As now the Bearcats are going to push pace up. Only a minute in and Asher Endorf gets it to fall. Crowd goes crazy. Now Gretna needs an answer. Rowdies are very loud. Let's see what Gretna has in their offensive scheme. Cade Cook, a little drive in, gets the mid-range to fall. That was cash money from the elbow.
I like Cade Cook taking that shot, especially as he dribbled in. 6'7", not many people are going to block your shot. Going to need a little bit of aggressiveness from him like we've seen this year.
As Asher Endorf with a nice little backdoor cut to Jacob Weber. He's on the board with two. Back and forth game here early. We're only 2 minutes in. As our scoreboard has not updated. Now it is 7-5 here in the Palace. As that three ball is up and no good. Rebounded by Wilkins. Now Gretna reset the offense. Haven't used a whole lot of shot clock. As now that will be a foul on the Bearcats. That's going to send Landon Porkowski to the line.
Yeah, Landon Porkowski, a good drive for him. He's been the guy for Gretna for quite some time. He's committed right now to Southwest Minnesota State.
As first one does ring true, foul was on Carter Lee. Carter Lee and Porkowski, we're going to see that matchup a lot tonight. The lockdown defender of Carter Lee versus the offensive machine of Landon Porkowski. As that one does not fall down, 1 point lead in favor of your Bearcats. Ben Johnson will have it now, guarded by Cade Cook. Now the Bearcats will run their offense. Almost every single student here is standing. As Weber shoots the three ball up and no good, but the putback by Ben Johnson falls. Ben Johnson got five on the night. Maybe he might drop 30. As Cade Cook lost it. Up, no good. That'll be Bearcats ball. Rowdies go crazy.
Yeah, Gretna, just some simple miscommunication on the defensive end for them. That time, Weber took a forced three. Ben Johnson just was able to kind of slide in there and make the play.
Gretna has not gotten on the boards tonight here early.
Yeah.
Considering that they are very tall. As Weber's going to shoot another three, they call the foul. That's going to send Weber to the line to shoot three.
Yeah, Weber that time, good shot there. He had it set up and he had it ready. Took a little bit of contact, sold it nicely, and headed to the free throw line for three.
That foul was on Alec Wilkins. First foul of the game for Gretna. 3 minutes down. First one does ring true from the charity stripe for Jacob Weber.
Yeah, Jacob Weber, a good first shot. Sometimes for shooters, too, they need that first free throw to go in, and those free throws can really help him start getting active.
As that one doesn't fall, maybe a little bit of an announcer's curse there, Bridger.
Always and forever, it's always real.
It is a real thing.
It is. There's a lot of poor small towns that I've really messed with unintentionally. Really is.
I guess. Won't invite you to invite to announce back.
No, yeah, I think, yeah. But, I mean, it's something that everybody's got. I mean, I'm not the only one with it.
As Cade Cook's going to shoot the three, top of the key, no good. That they're going to call the offensive rebound, or foul, offensive rebound by Joseph Veith.
Yeah, Joseph Veith, a good board there. Timed it up nicely. He understood when he needed to jump, jumped right at the right time, and he picked up a foul.
Right, as I said, to get on the boards, they have gotten on the boards. As now it's inside to Cade Cook, trying to work down low, kicks it back to Wilkins. Now it's over to Wilcoxon, as now there's 20 on the shot clock. Now Cade Cook's driving inside. Good ball movement by the Dragons. As that three ball up, and that is good from Joseph Veith.
Yeah, Joseph Veith right now only averaging right around 5 points per game, kind of that role player. I don't know, good start for him in the quarter, but yeah, I don't think Kearney's really betting on him having a huge game.
As Gretna switched to that 2-3 zone, it worked as Asher Endorf went up with the shot but did not fall, but it will stay down with the Bearcats.
Yeah, Will, another good board there for Kearney. They've been really dominant on the board tonight, able to really press that.
As now there's 15 on the shot clock. Ben Johnson working inside, has an open lead, top of the key. Short, that's no good. Rebounded by Wilcoxon. Now to bring it up for the Dragons. Now it's over to Alex Wilkins. Now to Porkowski. Thought about the shot, but now they're going to kick it back out. Reset the offense. 15 on the shot clock, 3:50 left. First quarter action, A7 District Basketball. Ben Johnson swats that ball back. He says, no, sir.
Again, Ben Johnson's that guy. He's been that guy for Kearney. I saw him do that in that Papio South game. I mean, his head was at the rim. Was able to swat the ball away. If you're Gretna, keep shooting. Keep taking the ball up. Keep forcing him to make that
look.
Play.
It was a good look.
It was a good look.
As now Wilcoxon lost it. 5 on the shot clock. As Porkowski's going to have to heave it. Didn't get it off in time. They're going to call the shot clock violation. Bearcats ball. Baronic's hyping up the Rowdies.
Now Drake Baronic is a high caliber guy. I wouldn't doubt it if he tries to steal jerseys before games. He's like, let me play. I'm ready to roll. Super high caliber.
Put me in, coach.
Super intense guy.
100%. As now Gretna, they showed the little bit of a trap I told you pregame, and then it comes up with the steal, but batted around. Now Wilkins will gather it for Gretna. Now it's over to Porkowski, top side of your screen, working on Carter Lee, picks up his dribble, kicks it out, now going to reset, 20 on the shot clock, as Straka gets the steal right back, has an open Endorf for the slam, and the crowd erupts. It's very loud in here, Bridger.
Great play by Colt Straka to see him up ahead. Straka slowed down, he thought there were more defenders up there. Endorf, though, great play.
This team is playing with momentum as Cade Cook gets the bucket to fall.
Yep, that's a good return too. If you're Gretna, you can't let that rattle you. You got to come right back.
As Straka has it now, they've switched back. Cade Cook kind of just playing up. It's almost like a 1-3-1.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a 2-3, but you got Cook playing up, and I mean, it makes sense. Kearney, a lot of those taller guys, Endorf and Johnson, like to play outside. Johnson can play in the post if he needs to, just not exactly what he loves to do.
As Ben Johnson gets the lucky bounce off the front of the iron, it gets it to fall. He's got 7 in tonight's matchup. 15-11, 2 minutes left. First quarter action, A7 District. As now Porkowski's going to drive inside and gets it to fall.
Yeah,
for
good
Gretna.
Again, good bucket for Pekorski. He's pretty used to that again. It's a pretty comfortable shot for him.
As Gretna and Kearney High, they're just trading buckets back and forth.
Yeah, and you know, it's early in this game, so you're still trying to figure everything out. A lot of nerves, big environment, so we're going to see a little bit of that kind of quick movements, quick buckets, but overall, the poise for both teams in this first quarter has been high.
Cade Cook has it now, guarded by Endorf. Now finds it to Porkowski, guarded by Carter Lee. Doesn't go off the screen. Has it stolen away by Carter Lee, and now Carter Lee is going to push on the fast break. And he has an open Weber. Weber no good on the three ball. Now Cade Cook comes up, or not Cade Cook, Alex Wilkinson comes up with the rebound. As Wilkins is up and no good for that three ball. It'll be Bearcats ball, 116. And another thing, Jacob Weber 0 for 2 on the night from three. Might just need one to go in to start having, I guess, a better shooting night.
Yeah, it's really going to depend for Weber. Yeah, Weber, it really should be interesting for him. You know, we've seen nights. I mean, he has the Kearney three-point record for nine. He's had nine threes in a game twice, but then we can also see games where he doesn't quite score as much.
As now the Bearcats will get it back. We're fixed our audio issues. But now Ben Johnson's going to drive inside, shoots up the floater, gets it to fall.
Yeah, Ben Johnson's so smooth. He understands leverage, and he understands where defenders are so well.
As now Porkowski gets it to fall.
Yeah, and very similar to Ben Johnson's shot. Again, Pekorski understanding where defenders are, what they can do, very quick and very smooth with the basketball.
4 seconds separating shot clock and game clock. As Weber has it now, back out to Strachan. Now go over to Ben Johnson. Ben Johnson drives, picks up his dribble, has an open Endorf in the post. Has it tipped away, it'll stay with the Bearcats. Yeah, 19.6 left in the quarter.
I like the play to get Endorf. That's worked on the backdoor cut from the corner. It's worked multiple times. That time pass just not quite where it needs to be.
As it'll be the Bearcats to inbounds. Has an open strike at top of the key. Calls for Jacob Weber. As Jacob Weber will now drive, they're going to call no shot. They're going to call it on the floor. As they're going to, but a foul, shot clock does turn off.
Yeah, and I like the foul there. I mean, he bumped him before the shot. Weber was not in a shooting motion. He was still trying to drive in.
Shot clock is off now, 15.3 in the quarter. Still no subs for the Bearcats.
No, and that's not unusual. Again, we've seen them do that quite a bit. Don't run a ton of kids off their bench, so they're used to playing, and these five are used to big minutes.
Now Lee has it, 10 on the clock. Now over to Endorf. Endorf gonna drive, calls for Weber, doesn't go. Spinning around in the post, gets the right-handed layup to fall. As now that will end the first quarter. Your Kearney High School Bearcats up 19-15. First quarter action, A7 district. Winner goes to Lincoln. You're watching the Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank. As we welcome you back to the Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank. We had a little bit of a first quarter replay at that break. As now, it's been some exciting basketball.
Yeah, it has, 19-15, some big plays. We've seen an Asher Endorf dunk. We've seen some spot up threes right there for Weber. It's been fun. I mean, it's been fun early in a high scoring first quarter. The second quarter, don't expect it to be as high scoring. You expect defenses to settle in. Both teams have a quarter under them now. They can take a breath and be ready to roll.
And let the coaches, I guess, coach and try and figure out this offense. has that three ball up and no good. Ben Johnson hits the deck, rebounded by Cook. As Cook now kicks it over to Veith, now inside to Wilcoxon, dribbling inside, little spin away floater or fadeaway. That was a nice shot.
Yeah, it was a good looking shot. And again, Gretna makes a lot of their money right inside there with those jumpers, and they're going to have to keep doing that.
As now Carter Lee has it, kicks it over to Endorf. It's been a fast-paced basketball. Not a whole lot of stops. As that three ball up and no good by Ben Johnson. Now Gretna, little fast break point. No, can't get it to fall, but Wilkins comes up with it, and now shot clock does reset. As they're going to call a foul on the floor.
Again, I like the call on the floor. That's two good calls by the referees. And both times, the reason being is that he's not in a shooting motion. Pekorski isn't even looking at the basket.
He's dribbling inside.
Yes, he's dribbling down ready to roll, much like we saw on that side for Kearney. And now Ian Piper
into the game. Checks back in. One of the loudest crowd eruptions after those 18 points against Grand Island. Cade Cook dribbling inside. Nearly posterizes Asher Endorf.
Mama, 6 foot seven. Get up, big fella.
As now that's stolen away, and now Gretna pushing.
Yeah, that one's going to be on the shot.
As Piper with the foul, two quick fouls in this quarter for the Bearcats. That'll send Landon Porkowski to the line to try and give Gretna this lead again.
Yeah, Gretna, good chance here, 19-19. Good move by Pekorski. Gretna wants to run and gun, and that's what they need to be doing right now.
And first one does ring true. Second one off the front iron, but Ben Johnson comes up with the rebound. And almost crosses up Joseph Veith. And almost does it again. Now Ben Johnson, a little fancy footwork, gets to the free throw line and almost hits it. The crowd would have went crazy if that would have dropped.
Yeah, they were feeling it. I mean, Johnson, smooth with the footwork, smooth with just about everything he does.
As that was tipped back and in by Alex Wilkinson.
Wilkinson, good play, had leverage, went in there, was able to tip it in.
As now there's a timeout on the court, Gretna fans are on their feet. We're going to take that timeout as well. 19-22, Bearcats find themselves down. You're watching the Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank. As we welcome you back to the Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank. 7-0 run to start the quarter for the Gretna Dragons.
Yeah, and a good start for them. Like we said, Gretna just needed that first quarter to get comfortable. It's a big environment, big pressure for Gretna, and I mean Kearney as well, but it took them a quarter to still get comfortable, and I mean they were only down by four after that first quarter, so they're just starting to play Gretna basketball.
As now Ben Johnson gets blocked back by Cade Cook, and now Gretna trying to push a little pace, little fake pass by Perkowski, kicks it out to Cade Cook, and they'll call a travel. Perkowski did not really like the call by the ref, but ball is ball.
Yeah, Pekorski, I mean, you don't see it when you're a player. When you're in there like that, you think that's one step, but it was the slide. His foot stayed on the ground, yes, but after that rug was pulled out off of the defender, that foot slid, and off the slide like that, that is a travel.
As now Straka picked up his dribble, can't go anywhere with it. And he forces the pass, Cade Cook lays out for her and comes up with another steal. Yeah, Bearcats out of system right now.
Cade Cook, two good plays defensively. The block on Johnson and then over there able to scoop the ball up from Weber.
As Piper went to the scorer's table, Bearcats need an answer. Momentum in favor of the Gretna Dragons.
Yeah, right now Gretna, I wouldn't say in control, really nobody's in control of this game, but overall able to do a lot of things right there. Pokorsky just patiently waiting and able to get a play.
As now Wilcoxon comes up with the steal off of Jacob Weber, showed a little trap, kind of picked it out from behind him. As now once again, three straight steals off of Bearcat possessions.
Yeah, Kearney kind of out of sorts right now. It looks like they don't know what they're doing offensively. I mean, it looks like all of them want to do a different thing.
As now Veith goes up for it, gets called for the foul. That's going to be Weber's second.
Yeah, Weber's got a box out there. I mean, Veith was jumping right with him. You box out, you get that board.
Joseph Veith go to the line to give Gretna one of the largest leads of the night. 4:47, second quarter action. A7 District winner to PBA. First one's up and no good from the charity stripe. As Piper checks in, Weber will head to the bench. Weber telling his teammate, my bad, guys, I'll get up next time.
Yeah, Weber just got to relax. I mean, his shot will be open. He's just got to stop forcing it.
As second one does ring true.
But what I'm saying with Weber is sometimes he gets a little antsy, tries to force himself, tries to think, if I don't score, we're not going to win. Facilitate. If your shots aren't quite falling, facilitate. You know, try to get in a different part of the game. Try to be involved in all parts of it. So right now, I'm sure that's the same thing Coach Bronick's telling him. It's stuff that coaches tell you at every single level of basketball.
But we have seen Jacob Weber make some of these circus shots.
Oh, for sure, we have.
Sometimes he shoots and it just happens to go in.
Yeah.
It's insane. But now Strzok is going to drive. Down four, picks up his dribble, causing some trouble. They're going to call the foul on Chase Doble.
Yeah, Doble, I mean, he was doing the right thing. Just when you start going in for the hug, you can't do that in the rules of basketball. The NSAA has not passed the hug as a viable defensive maneuver. So we're still waiting on that one. But Doble, he was good right until he fully stretched the arms out.
As Piper's going to shoot the three ball, up and no good on his first attempt of the night.
Yeah, deep three there for Piper. Pokorsky right on him. Would have been a tough make.
It was a deep three, too.
It was.
It was almost right next to the sideline.
His feet were about a foot away off that sideline.
As now that'll be Cook to shoot, and he is cash.
Cade Cook, a big night already for him. Some defensive stops, a nice turnaround dunk, and a three to go with it.
Now Ben Johnson's going to drive inside, counting it on the floor again.
Yeah, and again, not in the shooting motion. After the whistle was called, Johnson gathered himself.
As Piper heads back to the bench, Weber comes back in. These quick substitutions for the Bearcats have not been good so far. As they find themselves down seven, Ben Johnson working in the post, has an open Weber. That's good. Weber's got one three ball on the night. Maybe that's something that might kickstart it for the Bearcats. As now Gretna up four, 3:40. As that is an easy up and in Alex Wilkinson.
Quick turn from Wilkinson. That's a high IQ move. He saw where the knee was. You notice when he's feeling back like that, he's trying to see where the weight is dispersed. He saw right where it was, and I mean, it was a snap and he's in. That's a quick move.
As now Straka over to Lee. Lee and Straka, 0 points. Only people that have scored are Jacob Weber, Endorf, and Ben Johnson, as that's another three ball by the Bearcats.
12 points already for Ben Johnson. Something we're pretty used to from him at this point.
Maybe take a little bit of revenge for only scoring two against Grandin as Perkowski gets it to fall again for the Dragons.
Yeah, Pokorsky let it fall. No real help from Johnson in there. I was kind of waiting for him to come help on the backside.
As Endorf gets it to fall. As now that'll be a timeout.
That's a 30-second timeout taken here by Kearney. We'll stay right here.
We're going to stay right here as I try to tell our producer.
Yeah, coaches from Kearney not happy. They wanted a foul there on Endorf.
Would have been a nice and one.
Would have been for Kearney, but overall, timeout taken now. You're right back within 3 points, going back and forth the whole time. Endorf had a strong start as well. Scoring-wise, not a ton, but assists. He's been able to go in and facilitate. And that Weber three, that's a set play Kearney runs a lot. They run Weber almost off like an elevator play with two guys out there that set a screen. And Johnson, a tough pass, hooked it behind the basket and was able to swing it in. It's the same thing as the elevator play you see at the top of the key. It's just in the corner.
And now the Bearcats find themselves down three, 2:46 before half.
And you know, Pekorski, a good bucket for him on the other end. Kearney not exactly helping on defense down low, so Pekorski's having a day with these one-on-one matchups.
Maybe you want to see the Bearcats switch to a zone defense, try and get inside that little help defense
see,
in the post.
I wouldn't say switch to a zone. I mean, it's only three.
Woo! Yes, that was a nice up and in.
Yeah, Cade Cook, my goodness, two big dunks for him, one on the turnaround. That time, his guy lost him and he took flight.
As Weber's going to shoot the three, miss it out to the left, and now Perkowski comes up with the rebound. Weber still 1-for-4 on the night from three balls.
That Cade Cook dunk was sweet. Set it up, off the screen, take flight. That was nice. I mean, that is a high-class play. In the lob, perfect. Could not have asked for a better lob.
As now they're going to stop. Call a foul on Kulstrak, because that's his second. One more, and Gretna's shooting. Still 2 minutes to go, and one more foul. Gretna will be at the line.
Yeah, Connie's going to have to be careful now and make sure that they're not picking up too many more.
As that is up and in by Wilcoxon. Dragons on a run here in Kearney.
Yeah, they've been able to make their money inside on just simple plays that time with Wilcoxon. Pretty simple textbook drawn up play, and he was able to knock it home for two.
They've scored 19 in this quarter.
Yeah.
To Kearney's eight. Straka has it now, 140. Stolen away by Cade Cook. That was a mismatch. Now a little cherry picking by Alec Wilkins gets it done for Gretna to bring the lead to nine.
Gretna, like we talked about, they want to make this a track meet. They want to make this a transitional basketball game, and that's what they're starting to do late in the second quarter.
As Endorf's going to drive a little Euro step. Struck a three ball, much needed, no good. And now Alec Wilkinson comes up with the ball.
Yeah, another good close out there by Gretna. They were really looking for the Euro step there from Endorf. That defense came right in and collapsed on Endorf.
As now we're going to tick below a minute before halftime. 20 on the shot clock. As Wilkinson airballs the three. Now Bearcats going to push pace. Down nine, Carter Lee, a little mid-range, no good. There's a lid on the basket for the Bearcats.
Yeah, two back-to-back misses for Carter Lee, and both good shots. I mean, a good set three, and then that time a good floater. But Kearney, like we talked about, starting to stall out a little bit in the second quarter.
Played a fast and physical first quarter. This quarter can't quite get anything to fall. As Wilkinson, same spot, three, no good. As Ben Johnson comes up with this, shot clock will go dark. I took that from you, by the way.
I took that from Carlos Jimenez.
Oh, I took it from you.
Yeah, shout out Carlos Jimenez, one of my buddies, works for the Clippers. One of the most talented radio guys I've ever gotten to meet.
Met him?
I did.
Oh, wow. I'm jealous.
That was cool.
But now back to action. Five on the clock, Bearcats running. Ben Johnson's going to drive. They're going to call the foul. That was a smart foul. They had a foul to give.
Yeah, I like it.
Now it makes it a little awkward. 3.7 left. Hard to get you need a quick play.
Yeah.
Quick bucket.
I mean, that's an awesome call out there by Bill Hurd to make it a little bit tougher.
As it's inside to Ben Johnson. Up and no good. Half court heave. That's no good. It was after the buzzer anyways. But we go to halftime. Bearcats down 27-36. We're going to come back about halfway through halftime for a little halftime show. But you're watching the Bearcats Sports Network brought to you by Pinnacle Bank.
$1,000 at the ABA Inspired Basketball, courtesy of Bronco Factory.
As we welcome you back to the Bearcat Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank, Asher Salisbury, Bridger Cruz. You're making me laugh when you look at me like that. And then the rest of our Strive crew. We're having a little halftime show. You can't see the half-court shot, but if we celebrate, then know it went in.
We'll let you know, yeah. We'll let you know.
As he has one more shot left.
Yeah, but getting to the game at hand, for the first quarter, quick. I mean, I think these teams blinked and they go, oh my gosh, first quarter's over. 19-15, we ended it. Now heading to halftime, 36-27. Gretna up by nine, really started to get things figured out in that second quarter. You're entertained by this halftime show. I can't blame
you. I am.
But
he almost made it.
I mean, Gretna really got things figured out. Two dunks from Cade Cook. One of them was a quick turnaround. I mean, he's here, comes in, dunks it. That's the best showing I can give you, that dunk. The second one, I mean, perfect lob, left wing, gets a screen, takes flight, two-hand, yamma jamma mamma. I mean, it was fun. Fun to watch. So Cade Cook, he's been electric. He's hit a three, had two stops. Pokorski, Wilcoxon, everybody from Gretna been getting their points. As we talked about before the game, when Gretna can pass the ball around, everybody gets their points and they can roll, and they're doing that right now, and they're playing phenomenal.
And the best thing about this camera is you can see when we talk with our hands.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm a very.
Here, we can reenact the dunk.
I'm very much so a hands guy. Like, it helps me kind of figure out what I want to say. I know normally the camera's about here, so you can't really see my hands, but anytime you can, it is fun. I'm always clicking a pen, and I'm always moving my hands when I'm talking.
And then on the side of Carney, though, they need to take that lid off of the basket.
I just got to relax. I mean, at this point, you're down by nine. You got a full half of basketball left. Not too big of a deal. Relax. Make the shot, get the defensive stop, and only focus on one possession at a time. Focus on your offensive possession. Right now, all the coaches, all the Baronics, they're thinking, what
went
wrong?
All the Baronics.
All the Baronics. There's more than one.
Only two, though.
But that means I can still say all the Baronics because there is plural. But for them, you know, you got to look at what went well. You know, what were we doing well? What do we want out of this second half? What pace do we want? How do we control that pace? You know,
And then also, though, they need to hold on to the ball.
Yeah.
They have had way too many turnovers. Difference between first quarter and second quarter, 1 point, two turnovers off of steals from Gretna.
Yeah, and I mean, Gretna's made their money by doing that all year. We've seen that. Game against Pembroke Hill, I'm going to reference that a lot because it was a fun game to call. You know, I really didn't know much about Gretna. That game taught me a lot. They're aggressive. They love putting Cade Cook at the top of that 2-3, and it works so well. It works so well to put Cade Cook up there because Carter Lee and Coach Straka are not 6'7". They're right around the height of us.
About, yeah.
We are not 6'7". So
we could be. They don't know that.
We're not 6'7". We're 6 foot max. But up there, it really makes a tough matchup. And right now, Carney hasn't exposed the post enough to force Cade Cook to go down there and defend.
But that does come with the troubles of every single player on this Gretna roster has the finishing abilities. We've seen it with the fadeaways, step-backs in the mid-range.
Absolutely. You know, Gretna's just playing a good basketball game. They've been able to keep themselves composed, keep themselves in this game. I'd like to see a little bit more help defense from Carney. Stay in the man, for sure. Keep staying in the man, do that. But I'd like to see a little bit more help defense from Carney. A couple of times we saw Wilcoxon, we saw Pokorski go into the post, and they took their time with a move, took 2-3 seconds for that move. No real help defense from Carney. I want to see help defense. I want to see Carney make it tough for Gretna to get in the post.
And then Gretna, they've just been playing fast all night. They need to adjust to the speed of Omaha Metro Schools. Playing fast, not using like 15 seconds or more of the shot clock.
No, and you know, Gretna's done that. We saw some cherry picking, and then we overall just saw some good basketball from Gretna. You know, able to move the ball quickly, but now about 45 seconds left. He's coming in listening to the game. You want to introduce him?
Do you want to talk? Hey, you're talking. You can say hi.
Hi.
New generation of announcers. Everybody coming in and having fun. One of the coolest jobs in the world right here. But as we can see,
I would 100% agree. You get to see games like this.
I get paid to talk about sports.
I don't.
But as we've seen with the Palace, it's full.
The nickname, the Palace.
I think it fits it very nice. I really like it.
Bearcat,
yeah.
Kind of a palace, like.
See, no. It doesn't make sense at all with the mascot, but it just rolls off the tongue nicely. The Palace.
The Palace.
But at the same time,
Carney High School Palace.
But Madison Square Garden is the Palace.
I guess.
So if we have
Hold on. What about, you're wearing a Nebraska polo, PBA, The Vault.
The Vault, yeah.
The Vault's a good one.
I like The Vault. The Vault is very good.
And speaking of that, winner of this goes to The Vault. A7 District Basketball. Like what I did there?
I'll give it to you. It wasn't too bad. You're learning.
I'm an announcer only at night.
You're learning.
Farmer by day.
Which is so funny to think about. I don't know why. It's just funny.
You should see how I dress at school, Bridger. As that's in and out to start the third quarter here, A7 District. Now Bearcats going to push. Pace had an open Straka in the corner, but Carter Lee's going to shoot the three. That's cash money. Get the Bearcats started here early into the third quarter.
The Fort Hays State football commit able to knock it down. Going to Fort Hays to play wide receiver. They could use him to heat up. Be kind of that third fiddle to Johnson and Weber. You know, it'd really be a big help for Kearney.
As now Gretna has it down six, just start of the third quarter. As that's inside to, I believe it was Mickelson or Wilcoxon. As that's stolen away, bad pass by Jacob Weber. Now Gretna's gonna hold it up.
Did you see Wilcoxon wanna pull that three? Wilcoxon saw it at the top of the key and goes, oh, maybe, decides
as
against it.
Porkowski now doesn't get the floater to fall. Bearcats ball, Weber pump fake, got the three ball, gets it to fall, 3-point game! Cash!
Yeah, a good play by Weber. Nice little pump fake from him. And then was able to get it done. Only his second three of the game, but it came at a good time. His third three of the game. Guess
I missed one.
Guess I missed one.
He had, yes, one in the quarter as that's batted around. As it'll be stay with the Bearcats. That's going to be an early foul on Gretna. Down three now. Bearcats have gotten their crowd back in this. Their replay on our score vision.
So a 6-point run from Kearney within the first minute and a half, a little bit less than, a little bit more than that. And for Gretna, yet to get any points on the scoreboard. This is a start very similar to what we saw Gretna have in the second quarter. It's just Kearney's having.
As Weber's going to shoot it again. Oh my gosh! Cash!
There's a reason everybody was so excited when Jacob Weber showed up to Kearney, and that's it.
As Gretna calls a timeout. What a shot by our camera operators. Our rowdy section.
That's full. It's a good one here in Kearney tonight. This is the fullest I've seen Kearney High, not a student here at Kearney. So it's a fun environment, you know. I always was promised that this place would be full one day, and I got my wish. I got my wish, Kearney's full, but Weber, big start to the second half for him. I was hard on him in that first half. You know, I talked about maybe considering taking less of these circus type threes.
But when they go in, they go in. A good shooter like Jacob Weber and Ben Johnson, when they see it go in the hoop once, they just can't seem to miss from there.
Yeah, and I mean, that's a big thing right now is Jacob Weber really feeling himself in that second half. But now if you're Weber, look for the openings. Keep shooting your shot, but now you got to bring guys out on you. So you're going to see Endorf. You're going to see Johnson. You're going to see everybody else be a little bit more open because the emphasis is on you. And just like that, though, a 9-point run. Minute 57 expired. 6:03 left to go. All tied up at 36. But my goodness, like I said, how quickly things can change in basketball. And that's being shown right here.
100%. Crowd is back in it for the Bearcats. Use the home court advantage to your advantage, I guess you could say. Advantage multiple times in that sentence. But Gretna ball, that was kind of a forced timeout. They needed that timeout after that run of the Bearcats.
Yeah, it's a good one to call. I mean, you have timeouts, only the first one used. You're doing fine.
As now they're going to slow it down, try and get a much-needed bucket, try and get their fans, the away fans, back on their side, back standing up and cheering, as it'll be Wilkins. Five on the clock, kicks it inside to Cade Cook. Thought about the little fadeaway. He's going to step through, gets it to fall.
Textbook step through move there. Cade Cook, good patience. In the post sometimes, you can start to freak out. It was phenomenal patience, came in quick up and under, and Cade Cook still having a good game, and it's a first point so far for Gretna of this second half.
As now, Carter Lee has it bottom of your screen. Once again, there's our roundies there, full. As now it's over to an open Straka beyond the three-pointer, Cash Money!
Coach Straka wide open. Missed one earlier or late in that first half. Able to nail this one for his first points of the game.
Good shot to fall in. Three-pointers are falling for the Bearcats as Cade Cook goes aside. They're going to call the foul. It'll be a shooting foul. Cade Cook will go to the line.
Which is exactly what Gretna needed here. Get to the line, knock one or two of these down, and get your feet back under you. You started out this little bit of this third quarter almost with your eyes closed. I mean, Kearney shooting lights out. Gretna, relax. Take a deep breath. You've been in games like this before, and just like that, you know, everybody's hearing about Kearney going crazy. Still a tie game.
First one does ring true, though, for Cade Cook. Foul on Asher Endorf. Second one does ring true. Asher Endorf, first foul of the game. He's played a very clean game. As now Weber gets double-teamed, throws the pass away. They're going to call jump ball. Calling a jump ball. It will stay down with the Bearcats. Down one. 4:40, third quarter action, A7 District.
Pekorski's saying he's really messing with that arm. I think he's trying to tell the refs that somebody was pulling on him, somebody hit him. I don't know, we don't have the replays, couldn't quite see it, so we can't tell you exactly what happened.
We don't have the angles as Carter Lee has it picked away, pickpocketed right by Joseph Veith and gets it up and in to fall. Easy fast break point once again. Fast break points have been the difference in this contest.
Gretna loves them. Really, really do.
As it's over to Straka. Straka gets it through the double team and gets it to fall.
5 points now for Straka. Pretty memorable ones as well. Both of them coming here quick.
Ice in his veins. As they're going to call push on Asher Endorf. That's his second.
Yeah, good call.
Second foul of the quarter on the Bearcats. Asher Endorf has had both of those fouls, actually.
He has.
As now almost picked away from the pass as Cade Cook gets to the mid-range. They're going to call the foul on Jacob Weber. Now that's his third.
Man, that's some chemistry from Pekorski and Cook. Fake the shovel pass, spin around, take the jumper from Cook. Weber, and I think a lot of people there were a little caught off guard by it. You know, you want to get the ball in the hands of Pekorski. That seems to be a lot of the goal tonight for Kearney. That time Cade Cook says, nah, man, this is my second half. I'm rolling with it.
As that one's up and good. 3 for 3 from the charity stripe in this quarter. Second one up and also good. Swish.
Yeah, 3-point lead for Kearney. For Gretna, and it's some sneaky buckets for Gretna. You know, all the momentum and everything seems like it should be shifting for Kearney, but Gretna doing the right things, getting some pretty textbook buckets and getting some good defensive stops.
Back up by three is the Gretna Dragons. A little bounce pass into Endorf. Carter Lee wide open. That's good, Cash! Cash from Carter Lee!
6 points now for Leon. Kearney is red hot from the three-point line in this third.
As now an open Joseph Veith as Ian Piper comes up with the hustle play, saves it, little between the legs passed by Ben Johnson, now over to Endorf. Lee, another three ball off the front iron. As now Perkowski's pushing up, now has an open Wilcoxon. Trading 3-point buckets.
This
here
one's
in Kearney.
This one's fun, Asher. I mean, both teams rising to the occasion.
As now Bearcats need an answer, find themselves down three, 44-47. Cole struck a little floater off the front iron as Cade Cook comes up with it.
Yeah, that's a tougher shot to make than you realize. With the floater, you don't exactly know where that ball is going. I mean, you're just pushing it up there. You're not shooting it. You're just pushing it. And Coach Straka, not the tallest guy in the post. There's a lot more to think about for him than just hitting the shot.
As Wilcoxon, guarded by Piper now. 10 on the shot clock. 2:20 here, third quarter action as he goes up and in, gets the foul call. That's the fourth of the quarter. Second on Ian Piper, one more, and Gretna will be at the line.
Good aggressive third quarter from Will Coxon and from the entirety of Gretna right now. They want to take the ball inside. They want to drive it inside. The reason is the more they do that, then those threes are going to start being open a little bit more, and Kearney's going to have to make the choice of what they want to guard more.
As that one's up and good. 4-point lead now. Couple subs for Gretna to get the starters some rest on the bench. As Weber comes back in, Piper goes to the bench. Weber's sitting on three fouls. Two more. He will foul out, but we still have a whole another quarter to play. As that one's up and good. The free throw shooting by Gretna, averaging 70% as a team.
Yeah,
they can't seem to miss right now.
No, and I mean, free throws win games like we've seen, and these points when the clock aren't running, these are the ones that become really valuable.
As Endorf drives his side, doesn't get it to fall, batted around. It'll be Gretna to come up with it, and it's Alex Wilcoxon. Now to Cade Cook, now to Perkowski. Now up to Cade Cook, almost like an alley-oop.
I don't know how he still caught that.
And now he's going to shoot the three ball, and he makes it. That's cash from Cade Cook. Timeout by head coach Drake Veronik. I think that was a much-needed timeout to stop the run. Basketball is a game of runs. Right, Bridger?
Basketball, very much so, a game of runs. We'll stay right here, only a 30-second timeout. If it was a minute, then, yeah, we would have went to break, but only 30 seconds. We got a lot to talk about. Gretna right now rising to the occasion. Kearney started off hot, had a six-point run to start the quarter, and Gretna goes, got it. We can match that, and that's what they're doing. An eight-point lead. They had a nine-point lead heading into halftime, so they're almost going to match one of their biggest leads. Great to see y'all again. I'm Bridger Cruz, with me, Asher Salisbury. It's always fun to see the announcers, I've always thought. Kind of makes it
sure.
A little bit more personal.
You wanted to wear a suit.
It's a big game.
With how much I'm screaming and with your announcing, I would be sweating and drenched. We both would. And how packed this stadium is, the Palace?
Asher,
that's very warm.
Asher, I got four suits sitting at home that I want to wear. I was going to wear a pretty sweet suit.
What color?
Black pinstripes. Custom made from London.
My goodness.
I was really going to show up and show out, man. I was ready for it.
Black pinstripes as Weber shoots the three ball up and no good.
Yeah, good looking shot there from Weber. Just, you know, got the unlucky roll.
As now it's Gretna with it. Drives it side. Wilcoxon almost gets the nice, I guess, what would you call it? Euro step to fall?
Yeah.
But now they'll call a foul.
That time Straka had two guys and he was sitting there fighting for his life.
Chase Doble on the foul. That's his second of the game. Gretna not in foul trouble.
No.
At all.
No.
They have one person at two fouls.
Yeah.
And none of their starters have more than one.
No. They've done a good job this game of playing aggressive defense and staying out of foul trouble.
Play a very clean game as Ben Johnson has it now. Top of your screen. Passes over to Lee. Has an open Straka. Now back to Ben Johnson. Thought about the three ball. Now kicks it back out as that's a stolen pass. Now inside to Cade Cook, but it's going to go out of bounds. Hit the cheerleader as no one is hurt, but it will stay with the Bearcats, and the Bearcats narrowly avoided a monster dunk.
So you see that guy sitting. He's right covered up by the ref right now. White hat, light gray sweatshirt right there. He runs next pro, Nebraska.
One of the games of the week.
If they'd have taken him out, we would not have had we wouldn't have had so much great content. I mean, we can't take him out. He's a national treasure here in Nebraska.
Oh, for sure. As Straka has it now. 45 left. Over to Ben Johnson. Double team. Now to an open Lee. Lee, three ball, in and out. Straka comes up with the rebound. Hustle play. Now to an open Weber. Pump fake. Three ball. Can't get it to fall. 4 minutes of good basketball. 4 minutes. Can't find a shot.
Like I said, sometimes the gum gets in the gears, and that's what's kind of been happening for Kearney a little bit tonight. A great, great, great good first chunk, and then they start to stall out a little bit. Now Pekorski just going to be playing for last shot.
Shot clock and game clock are even. Perkowski guarded by Lee. I'll say it right one of these times. Now it's inside. Five on the clock. No good. Ben Johnson comes up with it. Little half-court heave. Please fall. I want to see it. Almost made it. Crowd would have went crazy. That would have been an exclamation mark to end the third quarter. But we go to the fourth quarter. 44-52. Gretna Dragons lead. You're watching the Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank. As we welcome you back to the Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank. Gretna, one quarter away from punching their ticket to PBA. A7 District, win or go home. Because PowerPoints, well, I guess PowerPoints don't matter because of the upset last night.
Yeah, that's the main thing's interesting. As we saw, Creighton Prep fell last night in the birdcage.
As our advisor, Mr. Robert Goff, doing everything here tonight, is telling the entire Strive crew that they were down nine and tied them before Gretna got back on a big run as Cade Clark throws the boom and Bridger can't handle it.
Cade Cook's a monster. Cade Cook is three huge dunks.
Is he committed to play any college ball?
I mean, Cade Cook is good.
As Weber will get it to fall, much needed bucket for the Bearcats.
Man, Cade Cook's gonna have a highlight reel of his own on all three levels of the game tonight. He's got three massive dunks, couple big threes, some nice jumpers, some good defense. I mean, he's balling tonight.
As that's stolen away by Asher Endorf, Bearcats gonna push pace, a little three on one. Weber thought about the three ball, good closeout by Wilkins, no good on the fadeaway, bounced around. Ben Johnson will come up with it. Drives inside, no good, as that's gonna go out of bounds. And it'll go to Gretna.
Yeah, and Carney right now upset about the no call. I think like probably seven fouls could have been called in that whole possession there.
100%. But now it's Gretna, up eight. Expect them to use a lot of the shot clock.
Yeah, at this point, relax, you know. Still be aggressive, still play your game, but yeah, relax.
As it's back out to Porkowski, I can't say that. But they will get the foul. I believe they'll call it on Carter Lee. Persoski will go to the line.
Nope.
Still?
Nope, yeah, still.
Oh my goodness. Who is at the line right now, Bridger?
Landon Pokorski.
Pokorski.
Yay!
Landon Pokorski.
Nope, still said it wrong.
Oh, my goodness. You want to ruin my thunder, Bridger. Oh, my goodness. But.
Carney, right now, got to keep your composure. Got to relax. Yes, it's a 10-point game, but, I mean, this is the game to go to state. You need to relax, and that's not it. I mean, relax. Take a deep breath. Even consider, you only got three timeouts left. Consider taking one here soon.
They will call the timeout. I think we stay right here.
Nope.
We'll take the break. Yes. You're watching the Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank. as we welcome you back to the Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank.
I'm Bridger Cruz, with me Asher Salisbury. Been a fun one so far, 6:30 left. I mean, Gretna up by 10 right now, really doing a lot of the simple things right. Kearney called the full timeout, need to relax. Take a deep breath and get this defensive stop here. That's all you got to worry about. Get the stop right here, and that's it. Then after that, you start worrying about offense. But for now, get the stop.
As now Bearcats, they came out in a little full court trap. Try and get the ball back, maybe some easy buckets. But now it's back to Gretna. Over to Wilcoxon. Nice little bounce pass inside to Wilkins.
And another time, no help defense there by Kearney, and sometimes that's what hurts you is when you get burned and there's nobody back there. It's going to be pretty simple for an open layup.
As now it's over to Straka, over to Ben Johnson. Ben Johnson a little frustrated here in this contest. Hasn't gotten the bucket to fall. They're going to call the foul. And one, maybe something that the Bearcats needed to start turning the gears in their favor.
Anything at this point. I mean, anything at this point, you're looking for anything you can get. That's a good drive there from Johnson. Didn't take too much time off the shot clock either.
Now Ben Johnson will go to the line to shoot an and one opportunity. Not going to say anything because announcer's curse is a real thing, but he gets it to fall. Once again, this full court trap. They want the ball back. Gretna, they've kind of planned for it. Bearcats, they've used it all season long.
Yeah, they have, and it's been effective some games, other games not so much. This time, though, Cade Cook doing a good job staying in there and bearing through the pressure.
As they're going to call a foul on Asher Endorf. That's his third. Bearcats starter starting to get into some foul trouble. Weber comes in for Piper. Piper's going to head to the bench. Only sub for the Bearcats. Hanson or Turner Bertrand have not checked in. As now it's over to Wilkins. Picked up his dribble. Now back to Wilcoxon. Gretna moving around, chewing up as much clock as possible. As they're going to call a foul. On Carter Lee, that's his third.
Yeah, I mean,
I don't think that's a foul.
Where you can
but
make
I can't say that.
Where you can make the case is he lowered his head. When he was running through that screen, he was right into the body of Cade Cook. And he lowered his head.
As now it's over to Cade Cook. Guarded by Endorf. Now it's over to Wilcoxon. Working in on Straka. Tipped away and back to Cade Cook. Shot clock does reset. At a foul. Now Gretna moving it around again. Dribbles inside. Doesn't get it to fall. Batted around. Carter Lee will come up with a much needed defensive rebound.
Great. So you got the stop. Now go down and get a bucket.
Now it's inside to Endorf. Got a little mismatch in the post. No good. Gets his own rebound. Goes up again. And gets the and one opportunity.
Persistency is key. That's what Asher Endorf is very, very good at. Got the first shot. Pekorski hit the deck. I like the no call also. All he was doing was swinging over. Well, yeah, and it wasn't malicious and had no malicious intent. He was swinging over to take the step through to get that ball in a shooting motion. And then he missed the shot, understood how big Cade Cook was, readjusted, and still was able to come up with the bucket.
Lead is now 7, as that is no good. Much needed free throw from Asher Endorf.
Yeah, would have cut the game to 2 possessions and not 3.
But now Gretna has it, showing this trap, switch back to this man-to-man defense. Now Gretna moving around, 10 on the shot clock, a little out of system here. They don't know what to do with it. But now Cade Cook has it, 4:30 in the game. Little fancy footwork, dribble inside, mid-range, up and no good, batted around. They're gonna call it Bearcats ball.
Good board from Alec Wilkins, but then Jacob Weber was able to be there and force the turnover. Yeah, long possession for Gretna. No points coming out of it. 7-point game. Good chance here for Kearney. Don't freak out. You got 30 seconds. You got plenty of time.
Still got 4:15. as Carter Lee's going to drive inside, goes baseline, kicks it inside to Ben Johnson. Ben Johnson, floater falls. Bearcats are making their way back.
Right.
As they're going to stop play. Shot clock did not start.
Right now, if you're Gretna, stop stalling. Stop taking your time. Play Gretna basketball. That's
play,
when you were scoring.
You're playing. That,
yeah,
yes,
that's when you were. That's when you were scoring at will. Right now, you got 4:04 left. You're only up by 5. You need to start playing Gretna basketball again.
As I don't know what they're going to take the shot clock to. I believe it'd be 5 seconds off, maybe 4.
I think at this point
they moved
just,
it down 3.
Okay. I'll say a lot of different ways you could have gone to that. You could have always just started it. You could have always just had them restart it.
But then they would have had to put more time back on as well.
That is factual, yes. They'd have to put time on the clock.
As now the refs are still talking over. What do you think they're talking about? Deep dish pizza? I'm just hungry.
I don't know. You know, they're talking to Coach Bill Hurd. Looks like everybody's...
Maybe some good restaurants in Omaha.
Good restaurants in Omaha. Mine. Man, there's a lot. Cheesecake Factory's like...
Okay.
Great. But I don't know if that's really like a tried and true Omaha restaurant.
I guess. But back to the action now. Gretna driving inside. Little fake pass. Going to reset. Now back to Wilcoxon. Top of the key. 10 on the shot clock now. Dribbles inside. Gets the much-needed floater to fall.
Yeah, Pekorski. Wonderful bucket from him. Came inside confident. Brought up the bucket. Puts it back to a 7-point game.
As Carter Lee had an open Endorf floater, no good. Batted around. Kate Cook comes up with it. You're not going to win that battle very often against Kate Cook.
Yeah, no, you're not. He's, and again, more good defense from Cook.
7-point game now. As an open Wilcoxon, no good on the three ball, but Wilkins comes up with the big offensive board. Back to Wilcoxon, can't get it to fall. Jacob Weber comes up with it. No, now it's Carter Lee up to Endorf. Endorf slowed down. 3 minutes left. Ben Johnson goes in as they're going to call the foul on the floor.
You got to feel for Johnson because he was fouled right up there. It's just then he was fouled again.
It's been a couple of those calls.
Yeah.
And again, the floors that I think the Bearcats would want opportunity.
And you blew the whistle. And you blew the whistle early. You blew the whistle for the initial foul, so it's not like you can change your mind.
As Ben Johnson has it now, he's going to shoot the deep three ball. That's cash! 4-point game!
Did you notice he turned around before it went in? Came out of his hand, and he was like, yeah.
I think we've seen that before.
He goes, that's cash. He knew it.
That's cash, but back to it. Gretna has it over to Kate Cook. Slow it down. 2:30 left in the game. Trip to PBA. On the line. As the Rowdies are going crazy, good camera shot away from our game, but it's a must see. As now there's 5 on the shot clock. Inside to Kate Cook. Kate Cook's gonna shoot the 3. Up and no good. 4-point ball game, 2 minutes. Trip to Lincoln on the way. As Wilkins comes up with the big fast break steal.
Yeah, silly. You got plenty of time. Relax. Take your time. Get in there. See what works.
Carter Lee wanted to get it to Jacob Weber for that big 3. That would have sent the crowd bananas.
Bananas.
As every single Kearney fan is on their feet here in the Palace. Now 1:30 left. 5 on the shot clock. Cade Cook working inside on Endorf. No good. Batted around, gets his own rebound, then gets it to fall. That was a big putback by Cade Cook.
Cade Cook is inevitable. 6-point game now, just bodying his way through this fourth quarter.
Ben Johnson step back, no good. Rebounded by Wilcoxon. We're going to have a minute. 3 fouls for Kearney High. 1 foul to give before Kearney's at the line. A little fancy dribbling by Wilcoxon. Now they're going to pass it around the foul. As there is the foul at a minute even. Down 6.
If Gretna can keep shooting free throws as well as they have, they could really start to close the door.
For sure.
But You gotta inbound the ball here and not turn it over.
As they get it to Wilkins. Wilkins will go to the line to have a chance to try and put this game to bed. Send the Rowdies home and send Gretna to PBA. First one up and no good. Lefty shot. That's his first shot of the game, I believe.
Nope.
It is.
Nope, he's had 6 points so far.
You just haven't marked it.
Yeah, I gave up on taking stats.
Too hyped. I have.
Well, no, I'm not even too hyped. It's just I don't want to get anything wrong. You know, I want to make sure that everything everybody sees is official.
Second one's up and short. 6 point game, minute left. This could get interesting, folks. Now it's over to Weber. Back to Lee. Lee in the corner, picked up his dribble. As they're gonna call the foul on Alex Wilcoxon.
I like the aggressive play. You know, they've let a little bit go, and if you could get that steal if you're Gretna, that'd be a huge play. You got fouls to give now. Yeah, now if you're Kearney though, 6 point game, two possession, ball game. You don't have to chuck up a three quickly. You know, you've got a little bit of time.
As Cole Straka dribbles inside, no good. That would have been a big bucket to make with the and one. But Cole Straka will go to the line to shoot two. Try and make it a 4 point game as Cade Cook, that's his fourth foul.
Yeah.
One more and he's out.
Yeah, and I like the idea for Straka. Wide open lane, might as well go in and see what happens.
As first one up and no good by Colt Straka.
7 seconds separate game clock and real clock.
Second one intentionally missed it. Got the offensive rebound. Jacob Weber for three. No good. Back to Straka for the putback. Bearcats are still in it. Smart play by Colt Straka. Did you see that coming?
No. I mean it was something. Let's give it that. And a good idea at that. You know, you make the free throw, doesn't quite work for you. We're going to roll through the timeout taken. 0.8 seconds separate game clock and real clock. I'm Bridger Cruz, with me Asher Salisbury. It's been an exciting one so far. 4 point game. If Gretna handles this right, no silly turnovers, they get to the free throw line, can hit some free throws, they're going to be looking pretty good.
100%. They are in the bonus.
Yes.
4 point game, 35.8. So shot clock is basically over.
Yeah, for the most part. And like I said, be careful, be smart. The clock is on your side.
100%.
You don't need to be looking to score here. No reason.
No. And look for a quick steal. Expect the full court trap. Gretna, they came out. And I'm guessing would be a full court trap. They have Ian Piper in and Hansen. Expect a quick foul here from Baronic.
Yeah, so that's why you put those two guys in.
Subbed out Endorf and Weber. Ben Johnson's played the entire game. This is the first time Endorf has sat all game. Expect Gretna to draw a play here.
Well, yeah, they're going to find something, you know, to get.
As they're going to call a timeout. They got two more left. We're going to keep it right here.
Yeah, and you know, a great defense from Kearney. Coach Baronic was telling him, face guard, face guard, face guard, and that's what they were doing.
And it worked.
Yeah, constant face guarding. Now if you're Gretna, maybe consider running a guy off a screen all the way down and seeing if you can't get something to go from down there. But
they did have an open Alec Wilkins.
I don't know if you... I mean, open is a
broad
term.
If you're a quarterback, you could fit it.
Yeah, but Lana Pekorski's not a quarterback. He's a great basketball player, not a quarterback.
I guess, but Gretna now has two free throws left. I feel like I'm going to have no voice tomorrow with how much I'm screaming. Once again, Gretna to inbounds. They get it inside to Alex Wilkinson as they come up with the steal. And now it's over to Jacob Hansen, lost the ball. Shot clock is off. They're going to call the foul. That's going to send Ben Johnson to the line. to shoot two. They called the foul on Alec Wilkins. That's his second.
Coach Bronick was screaming to try to get the timeout. Once the foul was called, he looks back and was like, no, I was not calling for the timeout. Not real. Send my guy to the free throw line.
100%. You could not describe it any better. But now Ben Johnson at the line. 26.6 left. Crowd has gone silent. First one up and good. Three-point ball game.
Jacob Hansen and Ian Piper, though, good defense, came in, did exactly what they needed to.
They got the steal.
And that is a sweet shot from our camera guy. Can't get much better than that.
Second one from the charity stripe. Up and good. Two-point ball game. 26.6. This full court trap again. Now it's over to Alex Wilkinson. Batted around, almost got the steal. Now it's over to Cade Cook, 20 on the clock. Cade Cook driving as no travel was called. They got a foul. They do call the foul. Carter Lee, that's his fourth foul. Crowd is booing the ref. They wanted the travel.
Yeah, they are not happy right now. Coach Straka trying to plead his case. I need to see a replay to tell you for sure. So Pekorski at the free throw line now. 15.7 left. Make both, put it into a two possession game, and you could really close the door on Kearney. Not for sure close, but it gets a lot tougher.
As the crowd is very loud, it's hard to hear me and Bridger talk to each other. First one up and good. That is clutch free throw shooting.
Yeah, and I mean, for Kearney, for any guy to be at the free throw line, you did not want Landon Pekorski.
The star player of Gretna, averaging 16 a game. At the line, making a two-possession game.
Yeah, he's got 13 points tonight, looking to make it 14.
Does so, 15.7 now. Bearcats got to move fast. Everyone on their feet here in Kearney. Bearcats can't get it off. Now down to 10. Ben Johnson's going to have to shoot the three. Now it's over to Lee. Lee's going to shoot the three. That's cash! Big three, timeout called by the Bearcats. That's their last timeout, 1 point ball game.
Man, oh man. Big time buckets from some of the unexpected heroes from this team. Lee and Straka for the most part from this game. Let's take a look at
it. As we have a little bit of a replay, it's kind of hard to see.
Yeah, but you
Joseph
could see
B,
you could see all the fans light up almost immediately from that. And that's going to be something that's talked about a lot in Kearney. But either way, like I was saying, Carter Lee and Colt Straka kind of play second fiddle to Johnson and Weber. But tonight they've had huge games so far and 4.2 left.
Now, once again, the replay. Here it is. As they wanted a travel, I believe it was on Cade Cook.
Yeah, they wanted it on
Cook.
They wanted it on the shuffle from Cook.
They played it on our big board here. Crowd did not like the reaction.
No, they didn't.
Crowd all saw it, did not like the call.
No. But again, we can look at the replays, we can look at it all. We were not there real time making the call, so I think that's a big thing that it comes down to right now. But
high school should add replay. I'm kidding.
We should not. You would have 5 hour basketball games. But now
for sure.
4.2 left. Gretna, get the basketball inbounds and hold on to it for dear life.
For sure. Go to the line and shoot. Hold on to it and go to the line as they have the play. They call it was a quick foul by Asher Endorf.
So
that'll be his fourth.
So Cade Cook right now heading to the line. He's got 24 points into this game, normally averaging 14. And I mean, Cade Cook's been the
guy
tonight.
Now this is where you go to strategy. Shooting two, make the first, miss the second. Bearcats have to go the full length of the court, zero timeouts.
Nope, too close of a game, Mick Wolf. You want to put this to a game where even if a miracle happens for Kearney, they still have to just go to overtime.
Okay, Piper checks in. They have the 3-point shooting lineup on the floor for the Bearcats. 3.1 left, 2-point ball game. Yep. Cade Cook at the line to ice it. We're trying to make a tie. Up and no good. Ben Johnson comes up with it. He's going to have to shoot a half court buzzer beater. No good. And the Bearcats end their season with a loss to Gretna.
Yeah, talk about a great game from the Gretna Bearcats. Bared with it the whole game, rode out the storms, and they're heading to Lincoln off of a season to remember for the Gretna Dragons. Man, oh man, you want to talk about a lot of emotions for these guys. It's hard not to get some goosebumps when you're really thinking about Gretna going to the state championship this year.
It's hard to think that if that shot fell, Bearcats are going to PBA. As now we're going to change camera angles over to us. Now for a little post-game show. As Bridger, you're not really upset as I am, but you're also from Kennesaw.
Yeah, and you know, I'm here for a good basketball game, and I'm here to give you all the action, so that's what I'm going to do.
It was a very good basketball game.
For both teams, riding out the storm, two-point game to end it, but for Kearney, couple too many untimely turnovers. I think that's what did it, and for Gretna, doing the simple things. They did the simple things well throughout most of that game, and that's what did it. They survived the strong surges from Kearney, and then there at the end, the clutch free throw shooting from Pekorski, from Cook. Cade Cook finished with 25 points, three dunks. How many defensive possessions? I mean, I could talk about him all night, man.
Just keep going with it.
Whew, he had himself a day, and that's what he needed. Everybody was so tuned in onto Pekorski, but Cade Cook was the guy from all three levels of that offensive end, and then on the defensive end, made some plays as well. And like I said, let's go back down to the court now, take a look at Gretna as they go to celebrate with head coach Bill Hurd. And man, oh man, emotions for this Gretna basketball team.
As I believe, actually, no, we're gonna play a little replay package of the game.
Yeah, we'll take a look at it now. Asher Endorf got the fireworks started. He hit the first dunk. And then Kearney came off to that quick start. But Gretna firing back quickly. But Ben Johnson, he can't be sad about the night he had. Had himself a huge night of basketball like he always does. Jacob Weber, first half from the three-point line, wasn't quite feeling himself. Second half to start that third quarter, man, oh man, was he hot. Rolling
inside. Ben
Johnson did
drop 22 on the night.
He did. Johnson had 22, second to only Cade Cook with 25. And it was plays like this, taking it right at Cook, doing what he could. And like we said, Johnson going downhill, such a tough guy to stop. Such a tough guy.
For sure, as we finish out the replays, I don't know how long this video is.
We'll keep talking through it all. Johnson, deep threes. I don't know somebody that's quite as confident as Ben Johnson that I've seen that's so confident to shoot the ball closer to the volleyball line than the three-point line, release it, and walk away. But for Gretna, like we said, the simple things, that's what does it. And tonight, that's what they did. They did the simple things well, and they got it done for their team and rode out the storm, you know. They survived a lot. Kearney came out third quarter, a six-point run to start the third quarter.
Oh,
Gretna survived it.
It was a game of runs to, like, 100%. Bearcats getting on a run, and then Gretna answering right back. But Gretna, 20-5, proving to 25 going to PBA.
Yeah. One of the premier teams to look out for. This Class A district, state is going to be loaded. Bell West, Millard North,
Southeast,
Gretna,
prep.
Southeast.
Prep.
Yeah, now Prep. If it all works out, Prep should get in.
Depending on the game tonight between
Papio
South.
Yeah, that should all kind of be determined. But, you know, any of those three teams coming in going to be contenders should be a really awesome state tournament this year.
100%. And you'll be on the call.
I'll have a lot
for
of them.
For the quarters and semis.
Oh, yeah, I'll have a lot of them. I'll be busy.
Maybe me, I would like to.
You can always come down and hang out.
Oh, for sure. The duo, Asher Salisbury, Bridger Cruz, and then the rest of our Strive crew. We're going to cut our mics. Congrats to Gretna in, advancing to PBA, the Vault State Tournament Basketball coming up in 2 weeks.
Girls, this week. Asher, anything else to say?
Good season by the Bearcats. Sad that the seniors graduating, but next year's going to be fun. Ben Johnson, Jacob Weber, that's something to look out for, the duo.
Yeah, those two coming back, that should be dangerous. But
plus then, but also some of the underclassmen coming up.
Should be fun. But for now, we're going to turn our mics off. Asher, thank you so much for welcoming me in. It's been a historic game, to say the least. But for now, I'm Bridger Cruz signing off. Tell somebody you love them and have a great rest of your night.
And then the rest of our Strive crew and Asher Salisbury, probably my last basketball game, maybe. But signing off, you're watching the Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by Pinnacle Bank.